What's up, guys? It's Bradley Overrated bringing you another Overrated review, and today's game we are tackling is World War Z, a Left 4 Dead clone type of game. And if you're into zombie games and you're into zombie games still in 2019, this is definitely a game that I would highly recommend. And without further ado, let's jump right into this review now. So World War Z really is a Left 4 Dead type of game. You and three other teammates must work together to survive the zombie apocalypse. What's really unique about it is just like Left 4 Dead, you have certain sections that you need to complete, get through each checkpoint, and eventually beat that quote-unquote episode. The episodes, though, in World War Z are varied and they are scattered throughout the globe, including Japan, Russia, and even New York City. And I love the creative take here. I love going and seeing essentially a zombie-infected Japan, a zombie-infected Russia, so on and so forth. What is disappointing about that, though, is the fact that there are only 4 episodes in this entire game. There are 3 chapters within each episode, so in total there are technically 12 levels and only 4 areas that you can explore. And I just think, what a missed opportunity. For $40, I did want a little bit more gameplay and content for that. For example, it would have been really cool to see what their take on for the Middle East was, or for Germany, you know, somewhere else. Paris, France would have been another great example of seeing zombies there. I wanted more bang for my buck. There is definitely a shortage of content. But while there is a shortage in terms of episodes that you can play in the game, there isn't necessarily a shortage of what you can do in the game. For example, you can upgrade every single weapon that you find in the game, basically, and you can upgrade your characters as well. There are different classes that each character can have. For example, you can be the gunslinger, who obviously specializes in guns and can hold extra grenades later on. You can be the medic, where you can get stim shots to help keep your team alive. And what's awesome is when you have 3 to 4 people in this game and you work together and you each have your own class and you each specialize in something different. It is the best part easily about World War Z, and not only that, this game runs smoothly. I'm talking a stable 30 to 60 frames per second depending on which platform and what your settings are, but I never noticed any frame rates and I hardly ever encountered any major bugs or glitches. The game never froze on me. The fact that you can get this many zombies on screen with all of this crazy action going around, it's something impressive. The gunplay is nice, the characters are unique, the story is very minimal and silly at times, but you know, it's, like I said, it's a Left 4 Dead game, the story is just not the focus. I really like the environments of this game. They did a really nice job portraying an apocalypse in this universe. It's fantastic for all of these things. But if there's one big negative that immediately comes to mind, is the fact that I do not like playing this game by myself. I find it infuriating because the AI in this game, they are stupid. Your teammates, if they are not normal, if they're not your friends, they are going to drive you up a wall. Even if you have someone else playing this game with you, you're still going to be infuriated at the fact that your AI will run off with your partner and no one sticks with you. Or the fact that they'll be right next to you and they won't shoot the guy that's attacking you. Or even worse, they don't even pick up the med kits and use them appropriately. They're very, very minimal and useless at times, and that is just the most infuriating thing. I would even say they are worse than the Left 4 Dead teammates that you have to deal with, and that's very disappointing. But if you have a few friends and you guys are just dying to play a cooperative shooter game like this, it is awesome. I mean, this game is, at its core, a lot of fun. I am very impressed with World War Z, from the artwork, the style, the gunplay, the upgrades that you can do, the online play. I never encountered any errors in matchmaking, anything like that. They did a really nice job for a $40 game. It's not even considered a AAA game, but it almost gives you that AAA experience. Which is why I give World War Z, guys, for my letter grade, a B. And it could have gotten a B+ or higher if the AI were just smarter in general. And most importantly, if there were more than just 4 episodes when playing through the campaigns, I would have loved to have 5 or 6, just because I was so immersed in these different environments and they did such a good job with them. so I was disappointed to find out that there were only four. Alright guys, that's it for me. Thank you so much for watching. And if you enjoy this video, you know what to do. Hit the like button, the bell, subscribe, all that good stuff that you do in the YouTube universe. And I will see you guys on the next overrated video. I am Bradley Overrated, out like a trout. Have a good one. They don't stand a chance.